Too funny.
Oh, I love it. Yes, yes, yes.
Our school day today to honor and recognize a group of student athletes from West Brooklyn High School who have accomplished a considerable amount this year. And of course, as I think everyone knows, tomorrow they head off to Des Moines to compete in the state wrestling tournament. Kind of a historic moment for West Burlington for a number of reasons, but particularly in the fact that we have the number of students that we have who are going to be representing our school. And so I'd like to, at this point, have you meet and recognize probably one of the best kept secrets in Southeast Iowa, which is the West Burlington Falcon wrestling team. So the details probably that I'm aware of or knowledgeable of, but I just want to say on behalf of the staff and the rest of the student body at West Burlington High School, we're extremely proud of the accomplishments of this group of young men. We're excited about the possibility of the recognition they're going to bring to our school, and congratulate them on a great season and wish them the best of luck in the next few days as they pursue a state championship in Des Moines. Good luck, guys.
Thank you. McNeil's on the yellow and blue, and Brimsky's on the red. Coming up. This is McNeil right here. And the yellow and blue right here. Brimsky over there. This is Brimsky there.
Yeah.
Get any?
Nope.
Turn it on. Crosby, hard.
Is that any? Jimmy got another score.
look on that sheet to see what CI is?
That's him right there.
Be right under Mitch, I think. CI, at the next match. Clearly, CL, okay. Okay. Mitch wrestles these people right here, the loser of this match. Match 7. Pretty close. got a wrestler wrestling right now, Zach here. Can I call you back? Okay, let me call you back. I'm right in the middle of a match.
Thank you.
Did last time.
Good practice.
Come on, Mitch, take him back down.
Now take him out.
Come on, Ned. Come on, Mitch!
out there.
Oh.
just hold on there.
Hold on, Zach.
Don't let him do it, Zach. Just ride him, Zach.
Shoot! And you gotta shoot!
Torrington. Well, I'm trying to find out which one's Harris, and I don't know. I wish I knew which one of those were Harris, because he wrestles Harris.
What's his number?
What's the number on that?
We're fine for him.
It's 130.
No!
This is Beast.
Where?
Beast in this one.
No, right here?
No, Beast. I'll call that Beast in this one.
Okay, I need Harris next, though. One of these two mats has got to be Harris. These aren't. These are.
That's 130. That's 130.
I look for a 13.
Huh?
This is 13.
So what mat's he on?
Hold on, just for the bottom number,
has
to be a 13. Right there.
And Matt 6? Oh, okay. Here we go.
And he's red.
Harris is red?
Yeah.
Thank you. Number two guy in the state. The guy in the Matt 6. 130. And Swampert's out there somewhere. Oh, Swampert's on Matt 4. Swampert's on You want me to tell you about Swampert's match? He's on mat 4 right now.
Okay.
He's wrestling that LaFay.
What's that Swampert, the blue or the black?
The one, the black and yellow. Black and orange, I'm sorry. Swampert's won the red and the black and orange on that 4. I haven't been able to watch him. I've been getting Harris here.
My pipe!
What color did you say Harris was? Thank you. Look.
Find him.
I want. I want him. One of those guys is Brumster, the number rank, number one United guy. He wrestled this guy last night, I think. Thank you. on, buddy. Here we go. Very fast. And Chris was very smart. Thank you. that. There you go. Thank you. score is. Yeah, buddy.
Yeah.
still gas.
Right, number two, 5th place, 140. Matt Gunnison. Y'all know what they think. Top winner. Matt two, 140. 5th place.
He's doing that.
Top winner. Matt two.
Thank you. I'm the kid from Indianapolis.
Right. That lives up here. If so, I get them, I'll gladly pay you.
No, I know, Leo. I don't think I have a card with me, but
Jim's got that, doesn't he?
Yeah, and you know what, Jim? And so, we see, in fact, in 2 weeks, I'm going
to. Third place, Mark Jensen, hold on, Chris Sutton.
Working, so I made him come in and help me, and that's how he paid his room and board at my house. So even though he loves the sport and he was in there, he kind of had to too. So I wish him luck, and hopefully we get this Iraq thing straightened out before he gets sent over there. And here's our head coach for our high school, Mike Sayre.
See what I deal with here. I want to thank Bob Bowen, principal, Bill Nelson, the athletic director, and Jim Slicer, superintendent, for all their support this year. And certainly I want to thank the parents, and I want to thank Aaron Drain for coming in the room and helping out. I don't know if you noticed the way I was walking there, but that him wrestling some of the kids and helps me out quite a bit. We had a phenomenal year for a fifth-year program. Got a lot of young boys on the team. I don't know where some of them are at tonight, but I'll say something about each of them. We had a dual meet of 7 and 5. We qualified 5 for districts. We finished 4th at districts. And that's out of 12 teams, and then we qualified 4 for state, and that was the second highest number, I believe, in the area. Is that right? We figured out. So these guys did a great job, and I want to thank Jim also for helping, but that goes beyond insane. And then Daniela, I can't, what's her last name? You guys remember, can I say that? Oh, she's a foreign exchange student. She's not here tonight, but she, whenever we go into a seating meeting, she would always, our stat book is so screwed up. She's got some guy from wherever the guy was from instead of a name. So it's kind of funny. We were kind of laughing about that one night. Anyway, so I'll get on with some of the wrestlers here. The freshman to start off with, Nick Bernhardt, he's a freshman. He wrestled 112 for us. He finished with 11-16 record. He had 5 pins. He did a great job for us. He showed a lot of heart. He's coming on strong. I hear he chipped a tooth tonight. Way to go, Nick. And then these fake ones like I've got right there. And pick gold. Yeah, pick something. And then we're looking for him to be back next year and probably doing twice as good as he did this year. So, and Nick, he's earned a letter in his numbers there. So.
Little story about Nick, and he probably doesn't want me to tell on him here. First of all, he's going to be wrestling in Reno, Nevada at the beginning of next month. He's going out with my AAU group. We go out and wrestle in that world tournament every year. So he's going to go out there and wrestle with the big boys. Nick started off the season a little slow, and so I took a couple of my youth guys, a couple of my real young guys, and I threw him in there to wrestle him. And I went over there to Nick and I said, you gotta get moving. I said, Nick, these guys are beating up on you. And he says, well, what do you want me to do, just pin him? And I said, yeah. So I took a $5 bill out of my pocket and I threw it down the mat and I brought that youth guy over. I said, Nick, if you pin him, I said, that $5's yours. And a couple minutes later, I asked Nick how much more time he wanted. Well, he didn't pin him there. Second guy come in, I took another $5 bill out of my pocket and I threw it on the mat and I said, Nick, you pin that guy, the tingers. And about 2 or 3 minutes later, I said, how much more time you want? After I did that, you guys, this guy turned into an animal. I could not put anybody that weighed less than him with him anymore. He was doing push-ups between his matches, he was doing sit-ups between his matches, and I was actually kind of scared to go in there and wrestle him a couple times. This kid's the real deal. If he wrestles next year, I'm almost betting that he will make it to state.
Our next freshman we have is Dylan McPherson. He wrestled 140 pounds. For a freshman to wrestle 140 pounds, that's love walking the lines. And I believe he's got numbers already, is that right? So Dylan, you can get the letter.
I believe Dylan also be wrestling at Reno at the beginning of April.
Nathan Miller, he's a sophomore, he's not here tonight. He wrestled 125 pounds, he finished 9-17. His record does not reflect his abilities though. He beat some good kids, he had 6 pins. And he also showed a lot of heart and worked hard in practice, never gave up. And he also earned a varsity letter. And so give Nate a hand right now since he's not here. Brandon Schwank, a sophomore, 119 pounder, rep finished 19 and 12. He was fighting off the flu most of the year and couldn't hold his weight down to 12 and got up into some of the men at 19, but did a nice job, wrestled at sectionals with 102 fever, I believe, and he just worked, you know, wrestled his little butt off, but couldn't get through, just got sick at the wrong time of the year. We were real proud of him for what he did, and he received a bar this year, and I'm sure we'll see Brandon back, and he'll probably be at the state tournament next year if he keeps up doing what he's been doing. Ryan Paranoid, had a buzzsaw match, and he was wrestling 135. He finished 8-16, and he won his first match over New London JV tournament. After that, he was just a changed wrestler. 135 pounds in this area, or in the state, probably is one of the toughest weight classes. And he did all right. He did a real good job for us. We were real pleased with him. I wish he was here tonight, but unfortunately he's not. He said finished 8-16, so give him a hand too. Next four guys, no, I'm not saving the best for last, but they were the most noticeable on the team. We've got 2 seniors that we're going to lose this year. I'm going to miss them an awful lot. Let me just start off with Mitch. Mitch is a sophomore, 152 pounds. State qualifier for us. He had a great record, 152 pound sophomore. 32-10 record with 17 pins, which is just fantastic. And he went to state tournament, ran into a couple studs up there, and he was in the match the whole time. I think he lost 4-1 and 4-0. Is that what the match scores were? Well, he was in the matches anyway. And I'm sure next year Mitch will be bringing home a medal from the state tournament, and he earned a bar this year. Next guy is Zach Gajewski. He's one reason I walk the way I do. I have to wrestle that guy every night. 189 pounds, he cut down from about 200. He had a fantastic season. Did a complete 180 as far as wrestler. Guy went to the state. He's your second wrestler that has won a match at the state tournament for West Burlington. He finished with a 35-4 record. And I know him and Chris had something going on. And I don't know if the stats are right or not, guys, but Zach had 25 pins. which is phenomenal. And he also receives a bar for his letter, or for his letter. John Gajewski went to Hawaii. Somebody asked me where he was at, and I said he had an expense-paid trip to Hawaii, and it was one of the coaches at a seed meeting. I said, what would you do? And he goes, when do we leave? So he came out with a shoulder injury from football. He was kind of overlooked all year round by the rest of the coaches in this area. I had a lot of faith in him. I knew he would do real well. My goal for John this year was to get him into districts, and he exceeded that goal, and he finished with 11-6 record, which does not reflect his wrestling abilities at all. He's a very good wrestler, and he was just getting better every match he went out there, and ran into a couple tough kids at the state tournament. He had 4 pins, and he is also one of the first 4-time lettermen in West Burlington for wrestling, and I'm going to miss him a lot next year. And the wrestling won't be the same without John. So, John, you're here in the bar for his letter. Last kid is Chris Johnson. I don't know if you read the paper or not, but Chris and I have been together for a long time when I coached youth program also, and it was a good year for Chris. He got third to state. He finished with 40th, third, well, whatever they said on TV was wrong. So, and we couldn't get him to change that. I just told him, make sure your medal says that back thing is right. So he finished 40-3. But he only had 23 pins, which Zach beat him by 2, if Danielle was right. So we'll have to check on that. But I wouldn't trust that book either. But anyway, it is true. Chris and I have been together for about 11, 12 years, and it will be different for him not having him in the room. But It was a great time for him, for us, and he finished the year right with a win, and we're going to miss him. We're going to miss all the two seniors, John and Chris, but I guess that's the way it goes. So he earned a bar for his letter also. Here's a little something that they don't know about. And it has nothing to do with the ability. I had nothing to do with this at all. They pick 4 captains, and the team votes on them. I don't vote. And the 4 captains that were picked this year were Mitch, Zach, John, and Chris. And for their letter jackets, I've got them captain stars. And I'd like to give that to them now. Some of the highlights that John put together for you. They are pretty good, and thanks a lot.